right? DJ Killer Kyle on the ones and twos. You're listening to StreetLitRadio.com, and this is the Husky Show. Good look. For those who are listening at home, you're listening to the Husky Show on StreetLitRadio.com. Every Thursday, 8 to 10 p.m. And we are broadcasting live right now at Chuck's Alibi, 7301 Oxford Avenue, from 8 to 1. We still have performances coming up, but we are going to start the interview phase of our show.
We sure are.
Yes.
And I would like to give a huge introduction to Stevie Franks. I want to thank you, first of all, for coming today.
Yeah, yes, thank you for having me. Yes.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Hey, Mr. Franks.
Yes, sir.
Now, I was trying to get some background information on you, good brother, and I was told that you were what they call a dope MC. So when they told me that, you know, every time I hear about somebody being an MC, I'm always curious and always ask, what inspired you to even say, I'm a pimp, I wanna go do some vocals?
I mean, I don't know. I mean, I was always surrounded around like music my whole life, you know what I'm saying? My mom, she used to sing. My grandfather, he used to sing, playing the band when I was real little. Just a way for me to... Good. It was a way for me to like express myself. You know what I mean? I mean, I used to draw pictures too. You know what I mean? Like paintings and stuff like that when I was real little. But music was kind of like a way that I could fully express myself. So, I mean, that was one way I picked up the pen. I mean, plus listening to rap and growing up on like, I'll pass the mic, soul music and stuff like that kind of like inspired me. And then being around my community, seeing everybody else do hip hop, I just wanted to get involved with it, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, that's how that came about.
And can you share, like, who were your biggest inspirations? Like, were they famous people at the time, or were you inspired, like you say, from your family more? You know, what kind of inspired you more, or was it all the same? It had the same effect? Like, people you saw on TV, as well as, like, your family and people that you knew, and, like you say, the streets.
I mean, it was mainly probably my peers. You know, they were into it. You know, as a kid, you growing up, you trying to fit in with what's going on around you. So you automatically want to try to jump into the culture that's around you, and that kind of like inspired it. But listening to like artists, like I don't know, like it's funny how I got turned on to hip hop. It was just like it was a sound and noise. Like my uncle, he always had like a collection of hip hop. You know what I'm saying? Like his room was like the don't go in room. So he had a room where it was a big, gigantic boom box. He had L. Cool J, Fresh Prince Bel-Air. I mean, Fresh Prince. Who else? Special Ed, EPMD, Big Daddy King, Cool G Rap. He had all. I mean, it was like the universe of like hip hop in his room. And I was told not to go in there. One day he went to work, and the door was cracked. So I was probably about like, I'm gonna say around five. I had to be about like five, you know what I'm saying, probably in gold. So I started pressing buttons on that big boombox. Yeah, I didn't know what was gonna happen, but I started pressing buttons. And I heard like, it was real loud, like, because he'd always be booming in his room. And I think it was Special Ed. Special Ed came on. And I'm sitting there, I don't really know what I'm listening to, but I'm listening to it, I know I like it. So I started pressing buttons, and I knew the VCR buttons. You know, the VCR had stop, fast forward, rewind. So I started pressing buttons, and tape popped out. So I'm guessing, like, okay, tape must go in this way. So I looked, I picked up, I think it was Fresh Prince, I threw that in. Then I took that out. I went in Cool G Rap in, put that in. Next thing I know, I'm putting tapes in. I think I fell asleep on Big Daddy Kane, and I left the door open. I forgot to get out of there. So when he came home, he seen me in there. He said, boy, did I tell you not to go on home? And then, you know, it happened. Yeah. Right.
funny story. But yo, you know what? So you were like 5.
Yeah.
When this was going on.
Yeah. Really.
So very early in your life, hip hop played.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't know really. I used to write poetry too. I mean, I really didn't know like how to rap. I mean, I used to start like doing like freestyles and stuff and saw me about 10, 11 with like a homie and stuff like that. But as far as the actual rap, I wrote my first rap, I think I was like 12, 13, something like that. And I was always writing. I was in a group when I was like 17, 18. We was doing that for maybe about 2 years. And I needed to make money, so rap money wasn't coming in right away, so I did what was around me at the time. So I let that go for a while, and it was like, I did a little, not a big stretch, but a small stretch, and I just figured out, all right, I'm gonna just gotta take it seriously, because for some odd reason, this keep coming back in my life, so why not, you know what I mean?
And with your music, is there a particular message that you kind of want to be known for putting out in your music, or is it literally just obviously the way you tell your story? I mean, in respect of how would you want people to kind of remember you? Like, what message do you want them to get from your music, and you as an artist, you as a person? Like, what?
I mean, my style, if I had to name it, is self-therapeutic motivational reality rap. That's my style. So I say as far as, you know, speaking my style, so somebody can relate to my story, but you get something out of it. You know what I mean? At the same time. You know what I mean? So it's not just like, I'm just telling my story, but you ain't getting nothing from it. You gonna get something from it. You know what I mean? So it's a message, you know what I mean? Like, that's where I stand. Morals over money came from. You know what I'm saying? It's not just about being goody two shoe, it's about being a person of principle. You know what I mean? That's pretty much what I represent.
Okay, wait a minute. I don't know this gentleman, but I have to shake his hand because he said morals. In other words, not the money. Not money first.
Word.
Oh, the morals. Being a good person counts?
I mean, like, it's just like certain things. I wouldn't sacrifice for no bread. Like, I done been in situations where you had to hold it down. I mean, I don't know. I come from a different cut, from a different cloth. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you and your man, y'all in a situation, and it's bread involved, and somebody like, yo, he gotta go, and he put the money in your hand, that's your man, you ain't gonna take your man. I'm like, nah, bro, it's my man, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is part of the principle, you gotta put over that. You know what I mean? I've been in that position a lot of times, so.
But you a real man? You a real man, though.
Matter of principle.
You a real man. You know what I'm saying? And you know what? I'm glad you said that, because we were having a conversation today similar to what you're saying. And we were talking about how today, actually what we were saying, we were talking about how men in America, their value is how much money he got. Not whether or not he's a good father or a good human being. Or that don't matter. How much money he got.
Right.
And I respect you for saying what you're saying, because it's time for us rappers to wake up, you know what I'm saying, to stop, you know, spit this death music and say things like morals first, being a good person first.
Yeah, but at the same time,
I respect that.
At the same time, I don't knock them, because, you know, death is a part of life, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, you gotta look at it, they only speaking from what they know, from what's thrown in front of their face every day, you know what I'm saying? So for them to preach death, it's like, who's buying these records? You know what I'm saying? It's not the record labels that's buying the records, it's the people. You know, they antagonizing it, so you can't really get on them. At the end of the day, they gotta feed their families. You know what I'm saying? So I don't judge nobody on what they do, but I know what I represent, what I stand for, you know what I'm saying? And anybody with principles and has any form of common sense, they gonna relate to that. You know what I mean? I don't judge nobody on nothing that they do. You know what I'm saying? But I feel what you're saying, though, as far as like the overall. It's just about what's being pushed. You know what I'm saying? About being pushed out front. It's not, you know what I mean? Everybody don't feel the way they feel. You know what I'm saying?
And I don't knock that message either, but it's what you said.
Right.
What's being pushed out there is only the negative.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? My thing is mix it up. Give us some of the good.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Mix the pot up. You know what I mean? But, hey, good brother, I'm eager. I haven't heard you perform, and I'm eager to hear you perform now based upon some of the things you're talking about here. do me a favor, good brother, for the people who are listening, for the people who are here.
Word.
How can people get in touch with you if they would like to collab with you or work with you, or how do they reach out?
You can get in contact with me, StevieFranksMusic@gmail.com. Or get in contact with my people, MJSpokenWord@gmail.com. She may be in charge of a lot of my booking, or you can follow me on social network and get contact with me through there. Stevie Franks, the artist, on my Instagram. Stevie Franks Music, that's the fan page like that. Stevie Franks on Facebook. If you want to know more information about me and my music and what I represent, you go on my website at therealstevienfranks.net and you get everything on there.
And do you have any shows coming up that you want to tell people about where they can actually come out and see you perform?
Besides tonight, yeah. Got so much going on. I know I got a lot of stuff coming up in July. Oh, I have a show for people in the Rhode Island area. I have a show coming up on July 9th, I believe. July 9th. It's a Grimo Cypher show. That's out there in our Rhode Island. I think the next one is in Brooklyn on July 15th. And that's all the one I know of, so you know what I mean?
That's okay.
I got a lot of stuff going on.
That's okay, but we're really looking forward to you performing, and we want to thank you again for obviously coming on the show. And we hope you will come back. So once again, if you want to give your Instagram again to the viewers.
Yeah, Stevie Franks, the artist, Instagram. Like I said, like my fan page. Friend me on Facebook, Stevie Franks. Follow me on Twitter at Stevie Franks Rap. Like I said, subscribe to my website page, therealstevienfranks.net.
Hey, Mr. Franks, thank you for being here today, man. I'm looking forward to hearing you perform. And listen, guys, if he does something that you like tonight, maybe it's your business to actually support these artists with your dollars. Download that 99 cent single, go see them perform live. It's important that we support each other. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Stevie Franks, show us some love, please. And when we come back on the other side, we will have coming to the stage next, because she told me to. I don't want no problems from these ladies. And Nina Capone told me she was next. So guess who's next? Nina Capone. She's not hurting me, okay? It's not gonna happen. Nina Capone will be our next guest on the Husky Show. Mr. Franks, thank you, good brother. DJ Killer Kyle, would you talk to these people with your hands? You are listening to the Husky Show, and we are on StreetLinkRadio.com. Yes. For being here. Thank you for listening to Street Link Radio. Thank you for tuning in to the Husky Show. We're live at Chuck's Alibi, 7301 Oxford Avenue. And we are back. Thank you, DJ Killer Kyle, for, you know what I'm saying, talking. Thank you, DJ Killer Kyle, for talking with your hands. Finish my name a little bit, please. Listen, we now, and you know what, I was hoping that the artist would be here. I'm going to even give a little introduction on this here, because actually, last week, Sunday actually, Tone Love and myself, we went down to Industry Radios, and actually, I wasn't even looking to meet Nina. I didn't even know. She came out. We went to the office and we talked, and when this young lady started talking to me, I was just impressed and happy at the same time that her sister was like as knowledgeable as she was and had as many things going on as she had going on. And I said, yo, listen, you gotta come do the Husky Show. You gotta share this information with the other artists and with other people. So I had to invite her down. You know, I begged, I got on my knees, I had to make a cake. It was crazy, but I got her. She's here. Ladies and gentlemen, show your love for Nina Capone, please. Yes. So, for you guys who know her, you already know what the whole spill is with this young lady, but Nina, would you please, she could talk to you for like literally 2 hours. She got so many things going on. And she got some nonprofit things going on. She has things going on where so it can be beneficial to other artists. So I really wanted to come out and speak. So without further delay, Nina, would you please explain to the people all the different job titles you have and what you do, please?
How y'all doing? I'm
loud.
I'm gonna try to maintain with this microphone here. So I'm Nina Capone. I'm also known as Jamila Lark, which is my real handle. I am the owner of a tech firm, which is my business consulting. We help artists, we help people in general implement technology in what they're doing. Anywhere from set up an infrastructure to a company that you want to start to get your mobile app out and overseas as an artist. So anything technology-wise, we actually do it. I'm hands-on. I got a staff, I got a team to come together to do it, but I can also do it myself. That's one aspect of the business. As most of you already know, I am also an artist. So I'm out here, I know what you know, I struggle the same way you struggle, I deal with what you deal with. Also promote and grow shows. I'm also the CEO and founder of Industries Radio, consisting of lots of different hosts now. Welcome to the show. As well as DJs all across the country, they go live. We use technology to base the platform more visual, basically. So really adding technology into everything that we do. So rather you're an artist and you want to kind of take your stuff to the next level, you don't have to be local anymore. You can go worldwide, international, you can do what you want now because technology allows it and allows it cheap. What else I got going on here? My nonprofit. So also teamed up with another large organization to start a nonprofit in which we educate people on credit, on finances. We teach our youth financial planning, financial management. So it's one of the programs that we give to give back in the community. I pretty much go to different community centers, set up, do workshops. Like I said, I teamed up with other large organizations who actually supply materials for all this to happen. We develop the 7-course module. We give away workbooks. We give away a bunch of different things. So that's another one of the businesses. What else I got going on? I got more stuff going on in there. Yes.
Real quick, and for people who are here, I saw the program and I was really impressed because most of us in this room, and it's no knock to our parents or anything like that, we were never really taught how to save. You know, how much money do I put to the side, things of this nature. And she has a great program that teaches the children, and that's the best time to learn those type of things when you're young. So I'm saying that to say that if anybody here, your neighborhood, community center, things of this nature, and you would be interested in teaching the kids in your neighborhood, your community, about how to not be entrepreneurs, but saving money. If we teach the children that now at a young age, it'll become regular in their life. You know what I mean? So I was really impressed with that. Also, this young lady, she hustled her way, and her app is also in most cars, most GM products, cars, vehicles.
Okay, so our Industries Radio app is in General Motors vehicles, BMW vehicles. I mean, we are nationwide. We actually did the footwork to get out here to make sure that your music is being heard. So when we actually upload you to our station, you're not just getting heard when people log onto the station, but when people are in their vehicles, especially in those high-end cars, you know, they can hear your sounds, they can hear your music. So you're definitely in heavy rotation. We have a live stream that runs 24 hours where you can actually suggest, hey, I want to hear Nina Capone, you can type that in and they come up and play for you on demand. Dang, what else we doing? What else we doing? If I could let somebody else tell my story. What else we got going on? We got a lot of different things going on. Out here hosting, I'm also an empowerment coach. A lot of people, especially, you know, kind of getting out there, we don't know what a coach is. I don't play football or basketball and that kind of stuff. But I can help inspire you. I can help motivate you. If you have a business idea and you want to get it started, you want to actually get the foundation built, you may get stuck with that. You may say, hey, I don't have the funds. I don't know how to get started on this. Well, I actually help you build that from the ground up. And you can definitely check me out at JamilaLaurie.com, IndustriesRadio.com, where I'm at. The nonprofit site is Community Growth Initiative. If you want any of these websites, I will make sure that my boy here, Bishop, has everything. And you can also find everything on JamilaLaurie.com as well. What else have we got going on? We got candy and chips. I sell stuff.
You know what? It's funny you said that. I was going to say that, but when I went down there, this young lady believes in the children working. Her daughter has a little stand with snacks and waters and all kinds of things. And I just thought to myself, like, wow, it's one thing to talk about something, but it's another thing to actually implement it. And her daughter's worked with her as well. I'm impressed with that. And I'm impressed with it because, again, as I always say, this is not a color thing. This is about us as a people thing. We gotta come together, like at the end of the day. And what she's doing as far as having her daughter with her, showing her daughter the business, teaching her about saving money, teaching her about being an entrepreneur. That's why I wanted her to be down here, because I want all of us in this room to be on that page. I want all the artists in this room to not only be able to rap, but know their business as well. And that's where Nina comes in at.
And to add to that, it's not just about saving money, but it's about investing money. I have real estate professionals come down, and we teach how to actually buy properties without having any money. Everybody don't have the money to, you know, 20 grand, 40 grand to drop right away. So we actually teach you how to do that. We're actually opening an academy, which we just signed that contract today. So we're starting an academy, a real estate academy, to really teach our young people. And not just young people, I mean, we'll have workshops for everyone. Everyone will be invited to come out and take a look and say, oh, okay, this is what I want to do, and sign up for the academy. The academy is free. We mentor you. We walk you through the process. We make sure that you succeed. And if you're as good as we think you are, then we keep you on board. We build a team for you and with you. So that's another one of the things along, you know, with the money management, because it's money management. We teach kids about insurance. We teach kids about savings. We teach kids about purchasing products, ROI, how to invest their money. So these are all different modules that I work with a team of people to create, so we can give it back to our youth. They don't learn it. This is not education in schools. You know, I've been in the schools. I have to go to 21 and 17. I go to the schools. It's not there. This is not what they're learning. So I took it upon myself to create this program. It works. They graduate. They have something to look forward to. They want to start a business. They want to become entrepreneurs. They understand what being an entrepreneur is. You know, like I was telling you when you came in, I worked at 9 to 5. I ran a technology department. I was a young black woman running a technology department. It killed me. It was hell. But I'm good at what I do. You know, it took a lot to walk away from my 9 to 5 and work for myself full time. And each and every day is still as hard, you know, because I got bars. I got to go lay some shit all the time right there. I'm like, yo, I got to stop this for a second, go lay these bars, get off my chest, you know. But the key of it is kind of separating your time, understanding that it's not a 9 to 5, but it's my 9 to 5. And I have to treat it the same, you know. I always tell my clients, treat it like you're working for someone else. Get up in the morning, go into the office, do what you need to do, and then plan your day around there. So I guess I'll let you ask some questions. Y'all, I can do this all day. I'm a speaker.
I want to commend you because I actually met you first at the Erin Hunt Radio, but we were there early and I saw her with her daughter, and her daughter was working, and we were, you know, we were politicking, and actually you had some book. I wanted to mention, Nina had these books. I was actually blown away. They're for different, what ages are they for? I couldn't remember what ages they're for, but they're for everybody. But I was blown away because if you are lacking any self-confidence or lacking belief, or you just need to like reaffirm what you want to do, how you feel about yourself, she has got these, they're wonderful. I actually had to buy them from her because they are really dope. It's like a textbook kind of thing, but it's not. It's like a book. It's like a book you would buy.
Workbook.
Yeah. And it's got different questions in there, but it's so uplifting. I'm telling you, it's so uplifting. And yeah, I really commend you. And I think we need more people like yourself. So it's really good that you are doing what you're doing, you know, not just for adults, but for the youth. Because the youth is the future. And so, well, you know, you really, really, really are something special.
Yes, first off, I want to applaud you for being so knowledgeable. It's just beautiful to watch. I'm like, yeah. Because you got to know the business. It's very important as well. So, as far as like the music.
Mainly publicity. I do work with artists as a coach. So a lot of people don't understand me. I've been writing for 20-something years.
You look 20-something, but okay.
I love it. Yeah. But you know, being an artist myself, I've been in the industry. I was signed when I was 13. I had the opportunity to work with Abase Records, Sony Records, Columbia Records, and really get in the industry. Def Jam, but I'm missing Black. This is my best name. But to really get be in the industry and learn from the people that actually made it, the people that are there, I hone my craft. What I try to get artists to understand, you know, the delivery, the flow, the studio operation, opposed to what you're doing when you're on a stage, performance, presence, grace, really kind of getting in and showing who you are. I'm brutally honest because I rap too. If it comes down to it, Black can tell you I'm adding you. You know, it's like whatever it needs, whatever we need to do to get you to, you know, on your A game, on your A game. So when the audience see you, you know, I mean, every artist I work with, I feel like that's my name. You know, it's just, it's bigger than it. It's like, you better go kill it. And if you're not killing it, best believe I'm coming up to grab the mic and we're going to do it together, you know. That's what we need out here. We don't have that. So as a coach, is one of the things that I offer. So a lot of people look at me on a business side, but I'm also an artist first. I'm an artist first, and I try to implement that into my programs at all times. So between picking out selection, song, style, you know, making sure that you're carrying yourself the correct way when you're in these industry meetings, they're no joke. Everybody's judging you when you walk in. You know, a lot of my clients are industry bound right now, you know, and they're like, okay, I went to this meeting. They judge me when I first walked in. So I prepare you for those kind of meetings. I prepare you on what to say, what not to say. You know, what songs you should actually play, what songs you're going to submit. If it's good, if the mix is good, if it's not. And I can go on and on about this, but I guess you get my drift, right?
Okay, listen.
So, you know, we try to dig completely into the artist to help the artist to grow, to blossom into, you know, their best. It's not easy. I've been an artist, you know, and I've had my moments where I was doing good, then I had my moments where I wasn't doing so good. You know, I had good songs, I had bad songs. So, I mean, it comes with the craft, but, you know, that's another one of the services that we provide. We do keep everything affordable. I'm not a $150 an hour type, you know, coach that you go in and you're like, I want all your money. That's not my goal. Of course, I gotta eat, it's my company. But I also wanna see you grow. And I'm hard on my artists. I'm hard, I work with you. I make sure we stay on schedule. I'm all about timing, right. And we work. We do it the right way, you know?
Do you have an Instagram?
I do, Nina Capone 1 and Industries Radio.
We gonna talk.
Definitely, reach out to me. I'm on it myself, talking to you know I'm a technology.
But keep on though, I love the information.
Thank you.
Does anybody else have a question?
No?
All right, back to you.
You know, I'm glad you asked that. That's why I wanted her to come out for any up-and-coming artists who are trying to do the business side of it and maybe don't know the business side of it. She would be very, very instrumental in those areas for you. So that's why I had to bring it out. And also, the character of people, the character was great. Everything that she said to me in conversation, you know, it's one thing to say something, and then it's another thing to see the verb actually happening. You know, like going in front of the store, this, that, the third. Again, I was just impressed because it's a sister, and she about her business. That's the thing, too, that impressed me the most. She's about her business. And again, when we have people like this that we know of, we're supposed to bring, we discussed this, too, we're supposed to bring each other to the forefront. front to help each other. We gotta stop, you know, not helping each other. You know, he ain't in my clique, he ain't from North Philly, he ain't from West Philly. Get out, come on, man. He from Philly, like, support the city. We don't want to see you know him. Everybody else support their city. We gotta start supporting each other. Because here's the thing, there is a lot of great talent here in Philly. And I'm not just saying that because I'm from here, it's the gospel truth. You know what I mean? It's a lot of great talent. So I know we put our resources together. Oh man, it'll be a problem for whoever. You know, so it was important for me to have Nina come out here. Nina, would you one more time for anybody who would like, you know, just give out all your information where they can reach out to you in reference to your business?
I have business cards. I don't leave home without them. So I will hand out some business cards, but we do have a live stream on our site. So if you want to promote yourself, go on Instagram, hashtag Industries Radio, and you will appear right on our site live, and I'll see you there. So hashtag Industries Radio gets you right on the live feed on our website. So, and that's constant. It updates every 15 minutes. It's a new feature. I'm excited about it. My tenant's excited about it. So, you know, definitely go on hashtag. You can get that.
Sorry, because you're being kind of modest. You're being kind of modest. Because the site she's talking about, she made the site. She do the IT thing, right? I mean, listen, you gotta understand like how difficult that is to do the IT thing and to be able to integrate this, that, the third. Like, I respect it immensely, you know what I'm saying? And again, we're supposed to big our sisters up when they're doing great things. And she is definitely, definitely doing great things. Nina, before we wrap this up, please let everybody know one more time where they can reach out to you if they need.
You can definitely check out my site, my direct website. Like I said, I give out my business cards. It's mybizconsulting.net. Again, it's mybizconsulting.net and Industries Radio. That's DA, Industries Radio. Check me out, y'all.
I want to thank you again. Give her a great round of applause. Thank you. Thank you so much for coming in.
What a wonderful, wonderful sister.
Thank you, Nina, for coming out. Thank you for talking to my folk. And listen, for the artists who are here, if you need information, when she comes off the stage, please go talk to her. She's a very kind person. Please get a business card. And let's network with each other. It's mega, mega important. Listen, let me say something real quick. It is up to us to build up this community. Okay, it's up to us to do it. And we can do it, you know what I mean? So again, Nina, it is only my pleasure. Thank you for coming out, all right? And listen, when she comes down, if you got questions for her, please talk to this young lady. She will help you. Everybody, please let Nina Capone here. Nina Capone, thank you for being on the Husky Show. Real talk, real talk. And listen, what we're gonna do is, we're gonna call DJ Killer Kyle back up here to chicken. Speak with his hands, but after DJ Killer Kyle do his thing, guess what's gonna happen? We gonna have my mans in him. He my mans in him. We go back like we go back, we go back. My man Montana Black will be on, and he will be discussing his show, which will be taking place tomorrow. History in the making, something great, guys, okay? So look, when we come back on the other side with DJ Killer Kyle, we will have my homie, good brother, my man, Montana Black, all right? You are listening to the Husky Show on StreetLinkRadio.com. Hey, Kyle, talk to these people with your hands. Good brother, DJ Killer Kyle. Yes, yes. DJ Killer Kyle on ones and twos. Going zero. Hey, baby, DJ Killer Kyle, thank you for the set, man. DJ Killer Kyle on ones and twos. Hey, thank you guys for being down here. Everybody listening on the radio, thank you guys for being here in the club at Chuck's Alibi for the Husky Live Network and Showcase event. Alright? Listen, tonight's been pretty good thus far.
It's been very
good. I had an opportunity today to, I didn't know about my man Stevie Franks. You know what I'm saying? I learned a lot about that dude today. I'm glad he came on. School homie, appreciate you for being here. And then my homegirl, Nina, Capone, you know what I'm saying? She came through with the knowledge, you know what I'm saying? Thank you for being here, salute queen. And now we have, is that Rocky?
Yes, it is.
Yo, listen, man, put up my tan. And yo, you ain't had to bomb that track like that last night. I heard that joint. You gotta do a song with me now. You went in. Respect. Seriously. I was like, damn, is she mad at somebody? Who was I heard her write that verse? Oh, I believe you too. Because you killed it. Respect. Yo, listen, y'all. Tonight it is my pleasure, ladies and gentlemen. Anytime, me personally, anytime my brethren or my sisters are doing something great, I'm not like, oh man, my No. I love it. It does my heart personally. What? I'm happy when I see my brother or my sister doing great things, wanting to be entrepreneurs, trying to move forward, trying to help the community. So we all should be excited about those type of things. But listen, it is my pleasure to have this brother up here. I've been knowing this brother for a minute. The first time I met him, it was on some, I think I might even met you with Hines and Chicken Wing. Yeah, and it was like, yeah, it's my name, Montana, blah, blah, blah. You. And that's when I learned about Montana Black. I was like, okay. You know, people are like, oh, someone said, you're like, Yeah, you know, everybody said that. And then when he spit, I was like, oh, that's why y'all was bragging about that boy. So, hey, ladies and gentlemen, and that's another thing. Just for the record, for those who don't know, I'm an MC too. I'm an artist too. I own an indie label too. I own a publishing company too. But guess what? I do not hate on my brethren. Because I want my brethren to own things as well. You feel me? I always say, when I got new car money, I want my staff to have new car money. When I got new house money, I want my staff to have new house money. Not just me. You feel me? And on some real, I don't want to be your boss. I want to be a team member. For me personally, a team always works so much better when it's a team. You know what I'm saying? So, teamwork makes the dream work. So listen, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I gotta introduce y'all to a really good brother. He's doing some great things. He's running Union 215, and he's responsible for a history and a making, which is gonna take place tomorrow. Hey yo, show some love for my man Montana Black. Montana Black on the Husky Show. What's up, big brother? Thank you for being here, man.
Hey, it is my pleasure to be here with you, The Blend, these wonderful artists, Nina Capone, Killer Cow, Eastwood. Like, this is definitely a pivotal moment in the music scene in Philadelphia, which you guys are doing here tonight. Straight up. I want to get that out there first and foremost. For some of you that don't know me, you might have heard about me. I was responsible for the Philly Jam concert series in Philadelphia. I was also responsible for the Thursday Night Live concert series that took place on Delaware Avenue when we had Papoose and 3-6 Mafia. The Philly Jam concert series ran from, 2003 to 2008. We was the only organization with just independent artists put 2,000 people in Club Polaris. No headliner, just independent artists. They did it right up in the Philadelphia Weekly and the whole nine. I've been in a couple of publications.
Champagne?
Yeah, from Champagne's, Talented Tuesdays. That's where it all started, back in Champagne's at Talented Tuesdays. And like Bishop mentioned, I'm an artist first. But I took 15 years and I studied the business. Not only did I hone my craft, to piggyback off of what my homegirl Nina Capone said, but I also studied the business. Nobody gave me the game. Nobody, like, you know, there's certain things that allows music to make money. I was talking to my man Stevie Franks earlier, like establishments like this, I don't know if they do, but probably they do have a music license. A music license is what gives them the capability to use music to attract customers. That music license costs money, and the performance right organizations that collect that money are non-profit organizations. So at the end of the year, they're collecting money from millions of venues. They don't want to get caught with that money because they got to pay taxes on it. They need to get it out to the artists that made the music that attracted the business. So if your music is monetized, guess who's getting that money? But if your music is not monetized and your music is playing in these clubs, you're making money, but it's not going to you. It's going to the artists that monetize their music. Union 215 is an organization network, actually it stands for United National Independent Organizational Network. We monetize music. We do music administration. As a matter of fact, one of the artists that I'm working with, Panda, aka Killer Bear, his single, Hate, is on the Tupac soundtrack. The Tupac movie did 27 million. Easy. What you think the soundtrack gonna do? Holla at me. You understand what I'm saying? Like, I did the administration for his record. I told him to do it 2 years ago. He come to me last minute. I ain't putting you on the spot, Panda, but I'm putting you on the spot. He comes to me, oh man, I gotta do this. So do it now. Don't wait until you're in a situation where you can, because he actually would have had two records on there. But he sent me the TV track for one of the songs that I had embedded with the recording codes. You know, and he could have had two songs on the soundtrack, but he ended up with one song on the soundtrack. That's still a lot of cake, though, you know? But again, what Bishop is talking about, history in the making is the new venture. It's on Nina Capone's website. It's on union215.com. It's on social media. That's union215, spelled out, T-W-O-F-I-F-T-E-E-N, .com. So, you know, outside of that, I'm working with a bunch of artists. My son is an up-and-coming artist now. He goes by the name of A-Meta. He has a video on Vivo. Right now, we're working on getting on Music Choice, MTV Japan, and over in Kenya. They buy a lot of music over in Kenya, apparently. Yeah, so we're doing a whole bunch of stuff, man. We're moving around. These History in the Making concerts are going to be held monthly. This first one is tomorrow night. It's at the Trocadero, 1003 Arch Street. Doors open up at 9 o'clock. You want to come out, get in our cypher. The whole event is going to be recorded. Any artist can get in the cypher at the end of the night, even if you're not on the bill. Yeah.
You know what, Montana, you know, now, let me ask you a question. Let these people know how to go about if they want to join Union 215 and how to go about performing at a History in the Making event.
Come out to the event, bottom line. Come out to the event, get in the cypher. There's going to be a live band, there's going to be a DJ. We can discuss all that at the event. We do hold auditions to be on our events. The music has to be marketable. It has to have functionality. A lot of people make music that doesn't have a functionality, that it doesn't have a purpose to be able to either attract business, sell something. It's a lot of drug dealing and gunslinging in a lot of music these days. You know, so in a way, it's marketable. It's marketable, but you know, it has to have functionality. It has to have a song structure. I read somewhere that the word "you" is in all the top 40 records. You, because you make you feel like you're talking to somebody else instead of just talking about yourself. The word "you," if you listen to all the top 40 records, they use the word "you." Hey, you. Yeah, you. And you. And you. So now the record is causing an emotion. And emotion is what causes action. Action is what generates money. That's just how that works.
You know what? I love the fact that you wise about what you're talking about. Everything you just now said is gospel truth. You know what I mean? Like, all these things are true. And the reason why I wanted people like Montana to be here and Nina is because they have knowledge of these things. And at the end of the day, we got to share the knowledge with each other when it comes to building, when it comes to getting to the next level. So that's why I wanted Montana to come out and explain the Union 215 situation and what he's doing. And again, I go back to what I said previously. We must support each other. We've got to stop with this, you know, so-and-so hold me back. You holding you back. You. For me? Yes, sir.
I want to piggyback off of what Bishop just talked about because me personally, if you know anything about me, sir, I like long walks in the park. But I'm in my head a lot, right? And the reason being is that before you go there in the physical, you gotta go there in the mental. If you've never been there in your mind, then you can't go there in the physical. And I just wanna, if I can share a short story? I wanna share a real short, it's probably not that short, but I'm gonna share it anyway. For a long time, because I lived in Philadelphia, I had a vision of being in a collision with a cop car. Like, they're coming one way, they got the sirens blaring, and they cut me off, and the guy behind me runs into the back of my car. I'm driving just as dirty as the rest of y'all. I just look like I'm corporate America, right? So, not too long ago, I'm with my daughter, my youngest daughter, she's 9 years old, and we're going to see her sister in this Little Mermaid play over in Delaware. And just like I envisioned, I hear the sirens, right? And they're coming one way on the highway, and they turn and cut me off. But in this vision that I've always had for a long time, I knew exactly what to do. So after I stopped, and I threw my car in neutral, I threw it back in drive, and I hit the gas. And the car behind me, as soon as it started to touch me, I was already moving. There was no damage done to my car, but the car behind him ran up underneath his truck. Car was totaled. And I walked away from that whole situation unscathed, untouched, because I was already there. I seen it a couple years ago. So I did exactly what I thought I would do. I actually even have a record called This Moment, right? Where I explain in full detail where I see my career going. So a lot of you, that's what you should be doing in your music. Tell your story. That's why the name of this concert is called History in the Making. That's what we're going to do. Everything that we're doing right now is being recorded in history. My man recording it right now. It's being recorded in history. So if, you know, like I said, go there in the mind first, and the body will definitely follow.
Yo, bro, what you just said is powerful. I don't know if they got that, but at the end of the day, I always say that, and I agree with you, the way we think, if you think that you're going to fail, you're definitely going to fail. You're already blessed into your existence.
I think with Henry Ford, whether you think you can or you think you can't, either way, you're right.
Exactly. It's up to you.
And
at the end of the day, positive energy, positive thoughts. It might seem like BS to you, but in the real world, it's really real. Your thoughts are energy. Your thoughts are real, and they manifest themselves. You know what I mean? So I'm saying that to say that everybody in this room, you know, you being an artist or whatever you're trying to achieve, you can achieve it if you choose to. Part of it is the way we think. Yeah, exactly. If you think that you're going to lose, perfect example. I used to do that all the time. I'm going to go for this job, but I know I ain't going to get it. I'm going to fill it out. But I used to do that all the time. And then look,
The crazy part is, I would be surprised when I didn't get the job.
What do you mean?
But I'm blessed with my own existence. You know what I mean? So I'm saying that to say, be positive, think positive of yourself and of others. And I know me saying this may seem corny because the norm is, you know what I'm saying? That's nonsense. That's nonsense. We all old enough in here to be on some. We want to do business. We want to do business, all of us. So, listen, we can go on and on and on with this, but at the end of the day, and I'm not trying to say anything to offend anybody. I'm saying what I'm saying because I got love for everybody here. I don't have to personally know you. You're a person of color. So, you know what I mean? I love you already. And even if you're not a person of color, you're a human being. I love human beings. You just have to be human. So, and if that's corny, let that be corny. But at the end of the day, that's where it's at. You know what I'm saying? So, Montana, listen, bro. You got to do me a favor, man. You got to do me a favor. I know you're running the Union 215 situation. I know that goes on tomorrow at the Trocadero. What time do the doors open?
Doors open at 9 o'clock.
And how much are the tickets, good brother?
The tickets online are $12 and it's $15 at the door.
No money at all. You know they're going to blow that buying tree. So they got 15. My point is this, y'all. Let's support each other's events. This is how we get to the next level. When you're doing something, it's my responsibility to come out to your event and support your event. When so-and-so is doing something, it's our responsibility to support. Once we start supporting each other, once the industry see that there is value in what we do, because we are giving it value, they will bring us the money. As long as we separate and not, we gotta cut that out. Let's come together. I can't stress that more. You know what I'm saying?
That's exactly what Union 215 is about. It's about the unity. It's about creating a cartel. A lot of people hear the word cartel and they think drug organization. A cartel is a group of businesses moving in accord, moving in the same direction with the same vision. And it doesn't, you know, there's a couple of, Street Link Radio is a part of history in the making. P3 Studios is a part of history in the making. BGB Beats is a part of, like, we're already a cartel. There's a group of businesses. Jamila Lari is a part of history in the making. This is the cartel that we're building in Philadelphia. Y'all have to understand, like, we implemented this back in 2007. The South was already doing it. They was already supporting each other's music, buying each other's music, and making sure that their music was monetized so that, you know, they would go in the store and buy the whole rack of CDs. Because that's their man's in them, but at the same time, those sound scans. I'm going to tell y'all something. When I did my first album, I knew none of this. I knew nothing about monetizing my music. I just recorded these songs and I put them on a CD and I hit the streets and I sold the CDs. I made a lot of goddamn money. At one point, I'm sitting on $150,000. I'm in Miami with Scott Storch. You know what I'm saying? Like the guys that Stevie Franks was talking about, Big Daddy Kane, EPMD, I've been on stage with every last one of them, down to Brand Nubians. In Delaware with 2 Chainz and Young Jeezy. I've been on stage with all these guys. You feel what I'm saying? But what I didn't know was that what I did not know was my music was not monetized. My music was not making me any money besides the money I was making from selling it physically. But I'm sure y'all know there's streaming money, there's synchronization fees. There are 13 royalties that a record produces. 13 royalties. Music is a whole nother wave, man. Y'all gotta get on that wave, straight up. Get on that money marketing wave.
Hey, listen, Montana Black, thank you for coming out here, man. Listen, I can't stress it enough. Please go out to History in the Making at the Trocadero tomorrow. The doors open at
9 o'clock.
9 o'clock. Come on through and support this brother. Support this movement. Now, listen, Montana, you did all that rapping, yo, right?
and I respect everything you're saying. I'm sorry, but I'm gonna have to put you on the spot a little bit, all right? A little bit. Listen, we're gonna start the, matter of fact, we're gonna have the performers get ready to get into that, but what I wanna do is, I want you to do at least one song right quick. Do one song, so these people can know where you're coming from. DJ Killer Kyle, I need you. He always got something, he always rubbing. Yeah, he always rubbing. Like DJ Killer Kyle. But listen, hey man, listen. Before we get to that, give people information where they can reach out to you if they need to.
Listen, y'all can get at me through the Union 215 website, union215.com, the Union 215 Facebook, all the social media, Instagram. Y'all can either hit up Montana Black on Facebook or on Instagram. That's B-L-A-K, no C, because E equals MC squared, and you need light to see. Never mind, we're not going to get into that. We're not going to get into that, but it's B-L-A-K, no C.
Hey, yo, listen, Montana Black, thank you for being here. I can't stress it enough. Please go support his History in the Making tomorrow, 9 p.m. at the Trocadero, 1003 R Street. The tickets are $12. Please, please support. Now, hey, do me a favor. Give Montana Black some love for me, please.